Well, it's time to wrap up our test of the Kawasaki Brute Force 300. Now, we've got about 200 miles on this thing now, and it's kind of a combination of use. You know, some just out trail riding. For me, it's a lot of chores, you know, because of where I live, you can use it to run to the post office or down to the gas station or things like that. But I've also used it a lot for just chores around here, whether it's clearing the trails, cutting wood, towing a rough cut mower out in the pastures, has done those tours well. We've also used it for some RV maintenance in an RV park. It's worked well in all of these chores, duties that we've put it to. Pretty remarkable. Now, you know, when we first tested this ATV, we were amazed at its build quality. It has held up well. We've just used it. And so far, now at 200 miles, the only thing, and it just happened, was the fuel gauge stopped working. And, you know, now if this was my ATV, I'd probably be pulling the sending unit out, which is right here real handy, and just make sure the connections are right, good, or something isn't stuck in there. You know, but, you know, not a big deal, probably, for those of us that have been around the industry a long time. I rode many ATVs without fuel gauges whatsoever. You just looked in the gas tank to see how much fuel you had. And another plus of this whole thing is this does have reverse, reserve. I just love the fact that, you know, some of these ATVs still have a fuel petcock with on, off, and reserve. This move to getting rid of that just annoys me, you know, whether it's cost cutting or what, I don't know, but I like having a reserve. Whether I'm out on the trail or whether I'm out doing chores and gas is getting low, I know I can always finish up what I'm doing, get back to work, you know, get back to the barn, get back to the house, you know, so it's not a big problem. One of the other things in the initial test we talked about was the parking brake. Yes, jury's still out. You know, some of us liked this because it's just, you know, you can just flip it on and off with one hand. And that was a big thing. I said I prefer this parking brake where you could hold a lever in and clip it and then it's on and then you can just do this to release it, but you know, to put it on takes two hands, where this you can just get off the ATV to go do something and, you know, just flip it on. We love the size. I think we said that before. We love the size, love the engine, and whether you're out trail riding, it just has a nice nimble feel, and even out on the trails, you know, it can get up and cruise down there at 40 miles an hour and, you know, not be breathing too hard. So you can get down the bigger trails, and then when you get in the tough stuff, the smaller size just feels so much more nimble and more manageable than the big 800-pound, 800cc ATVs that we ride so much. You know, like we said before, I sure wished it was four-wheel drive. Whether you're out towing the rough cut or towing the trailer, you get in any type of a bind or slick surface, even gravel, loose gravel, that I have in my driveway and stuff. You know, you can lose traction pretty easy with that. But you know what? Maybe like a good set of the STI black diamonds on here might make a big difference, give it more traction. I don't know. Still a four-wheel drive guy. And one of the things I want to point out, a lot of people give solid rear axles, swing axles a bad rap, but I love them for you, especially for utility machines, because no matter what you put on this trailer, how much you load it down, this thing doesn't squat. It's going to have the same ground clearance as it had, empty or loaded. People say, oh, they don't ride as good. That's a lot to do with the shock absorbers. Look at, you know, this is a subject for another time, but look at sport quads. You know, you put a great shock absorber in a rear end, you know, on a swing axle rear end, and they handle great. So that's not an issue for me. In fact, for something I'm using around here, I much prefer a straight axle, swing axle. One of the other things that we noticed that we really liked, unique, was that when the lights are on, there's actually a parking light switch or a running light switch. And, you know, something I didn't think about, but we discovered is really cool, especially if it's late at night, dark, or early in the morning, you're leaving and you really don't want your lights on, but you need to see where you're going. It's a nice little touch. And something, now that I've used this, I'm going to miss on some of the other ATVs. I think that's about it. We've had really, really good luck. This is a good value ATV, whether you're going to use it for your first ATV for just trail riding, or whether you're going to buy one for use around your farm or work. just can't overlook the value of this, because most ATVs now are pushing $10,000, and you can buy two of these for that. So that, to me, that's a huge plus. And again, except for that fuel gauge, it just went bad. We haven't had any problems in the 200 miles. You know, this thing has just worked flawlessly. It starts right up. The shifter goes right into gear. Everything has worked just fine. And then I didn't point this out in the initial test, but this is made for Kawasaki to Kawasaki specs by Kymco. I say that simply because there's no problem with that. The build quality of this thing is excellent, as we said in the initial test. The fact that it's not built by Kawasaki doesn't matter, and it just shows me now, after spending this much time on a Kymco, how far they've come. I mean, we spent some time on an Arctic Cat that was built by Kymco, and now this thing, and that fact wouldn't even enter my mind if I was trying to decide to purchase this. Maybe it would, because I know it works well, and it holds up well. So that's really it. Again, 200 miles, pretty flawless operation. Probably the biggest things that we love about it is the size of this machine, how nimble it is, plenty of power for a 300. The thing that I wished is that it had four-wheel drive. I don't know what that would add in cost, but four-wheel drive would make this probably, for me, dang near the ultimate just all-around ATV for working, doing your chores, and still being able to get out on the trails and go riding. So, and again, the bottom line is, with ATVs like they are, with their prices just going through the roof, this price point, you know, even though I thought it used to be expensive, is now a deal. And when I see what you get for the money, it's impressive. So I wouldn't hesitate, whether it was going to be your first ATV or another ATV that you're going to use around your farm, ranch, I wouldn't hesitate in purchasing one of these. And only hesitation on my part is giving it back to Kawasaki.